Hello friends, welcome to the channel Solution. Today in this video we will tell you about the different types of glasswares. This video is part 2 of glassware, means in the first part we have demonstrated about 10 glassware which is commonly used in the different laboratories, and today in this video we will tell you about the other glassware which are commonly used in the laboratories. So let's start. So our first glassware is glass slide, which is also called microscopic slide, and this is a flat piece of glass of rectangular shape as you can see in the video. And as the name suggests, this glass slide is used for the microscopy examination of the sample, means this glass slide is used for the examination of the specimen under the microscope, means we have to place the specimen over this microscopic slide before the observation under the microscope. Specimen means the sample of the blood or the sample of the tissue, means tissue for the examination, means tissue for the study under the microscope, or we have to cut the thin section of the tissue of plants or the animal, then we have to put this specimen, or you can say this tissue section or blood sample, over this microscopic slide, then we have to observe under the microscope. So this is all about microscopic slide. Next, this is called cover slip. As you can see in the video, this is a very thin piece of glass of square shape. And what is the use of this cover slip? So when we place a specimen on a glass slide that is to be examined under the microscope, means when we place a thin tissue section of plants or animal or blood sample or any other sample, then when we place this specimen over the glass slide, means microscopic slide, then we have to cover this specimen with this cover slip. And what is the purpose to cover the specimen with cover slip? Cover slip protects the specimen and prevent the specimen from drying out, and also hold the specimen in place and also protect the objective lens of the microscope from staining. Next, this is called watch glass. As you can see, this is a circular concave piece of glass, and this watch glass is used as a surface to evaporate a liquid, or it is used to hold the solid while being weighed, means while weighing any solid substance or any sample, we place this watch glass over the weighing machine and then we have to tear it so that the watch glass weight should be zero at the time of weighing, and then place the sample over the watch glass which we want to weigh. And this watch glass is also used for heating the small amount of the substance or as a cover for a beaker to prevent the dust or any other particles to enter into the beaker, and it is also used to hold the water and the staining reagent during the slide preparation. Next, this glassware is called boiling tube. This is a large tube which is made up of glass. Glass means here it is made up of borosilicate glass, and this boiling tube is used in the laboratory to strongly heat the solution. And as you can see, it is like test tube, but it is larger in size as compared to the test tube. And this large size of the boiling tube allows the substance, means allows the liquid, to boil freely inside the boiling tube. This glassware is called fusion tube. You can see here, this is very small in size and made of very thin glass. This is frequently used in the chemistry lab for fusion test, means to fuse or to melt the substance. Generally, it is used in the sodium fusion test, which is used for the detection of elements like nitrogen, sulfur, halogen in the sample. For this, what we have to do? We have to add the sodium metal in the sample in this fusion tube, and then the sodium is allowed to melt by applying heat. And when we transfer this into the container containing water, then it will break into the small pieces because it is made up of very thin glass. And in this way, it is used in the fusion test for the element detection. And this fusion tube is also used to detect the melting point and the boiling point of any substance. Next, this glassware is called separating funnel because it is used to separate the layer of two immiscible liquid. This separating funnel is of 250 ml and it is made up of borosilicate glass. And the shape of this separating funnel is conical in shape with pointed end. And this separating funnel is used generally for the liquid-liquid extraction method, partition of the substance between the two immiscible liquid, means when we transfer the mixture of two immiscible liquid inside the separating funnel, Immiscible liquid means liquid which do not mix with each other, not dissolve in each other, and remain separated as a two layer. And when we want to separate this mixture into the individual layer, individual liquid from the immiscible liquid mixture, then we use this separating funnel. For example, suppose we have to separate oil and water mixture, then with the help of this separating funnel, we can separate the oil and water individually. And how we can separate the two immiscible liquid? When we add the mixture of immiscible liquid, we observe two different layers. You can see here, this is the knob provided. We can open and close this knob. And the liquid which is lighter in weight will float and the liquid which is heavier remain at the bottom. And when we open this knob, the lower liquid will separate out first and then we have to close this knob and then again we have to open the knob to collect the another layer of the liquid in the another container. So this is how we can separate the liquid by using this separating funnel. And here this is the stopper, or you can say cover or the cap provided at the top. And while shaking the liquid mixture, we have to close tightly this stopper of the separating funnel. So this is all about the separating funnel. Next glassware is called condenser. And this is the top of the condenser. And this condenser is used generally for the distillation of the water or the volatile oil. Means when we boil the liquid evaporates, means convert into the vapor, and then condenses means convert again into the liquid form in this condenser. And then we again collect the liquid in another place or another container. This condenser is also used to reflux, means when we have to boil the liquid mixture for long time. For this, we have to fit this condenser to the flask, especially the round bottom flask, to prevent the solvent loss during the process of long heating. Means when we boil the liquid mixture, the solvent evaporates and goes to the condenser. And then in the condenser, again the vapor of the solvent condenses back into the flask drop by drop, and this is how we prevent the loss of the solvent. Again, this condenser is also used for extraction purpose, means when we have to extract any substance with the solvent, again we can use this condenser to recycle the solvent to prevent the solvent loss. And this is the connector of the cold water inlet, means here we attach the rubber pipe, and this is the another connector for water outlet where we connect the rubber pipe. And here is the connector, or you can say the joint, where we attach the flask like round bottom flask. And this is the outer tube of the condenser for water circulation, and inside this water tube there is an inner tube in which the vapor flows and condenses. Next, this glassware is called reagent bottle, and this is used to store different chemical reagents like acid, alkali, like dilute nitric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, dilute ammonia solution, and other different detecting reagents which are used for different chemical identification tests. That reagents are prepared and stored in this container. Chemicals are either stored in the liquid or the powder form, and the glass of this reagent bottle is anti-corrosive, means the chemicals can be placed in this round bottom flask for long time without any corrosion. And here is the cap, or you can say stopper, of this reagent bottle. Next, this glassware is called petri dish. And this petri dish is made up of borosilicate glass. This petri dish consists of two parts. And in the first part, we store, or you can say we place the substance, and other is the cover. This petri dish is mainly used in the microbiology lab for cell culture, like microbial cell culture. For this, nutrient media containing agar is transferred to the lower part of this petri dish to get solidified. And then this petri dish is kept for the cell culture, for example, bacterial or fungal growth. And we have to cover this with the second part of the petri dish during the cell culture to prevent it from the contamination during the cell culture. As you can see here, this is completely transparent so that we can easily observe the cell growth on the nutrient media inside the petri dish. Means this petri dish is used mainly for the microbial study in the lab. A German bacteriologist named Julius Richard Petri invented this glassware and named it as petri dish. Next, this glassware is called round bottom flask because the bottom of this flask is round and not flat. and it is spherical in shape with long narrow neck at the top with joints. And in this joint, we attach the condenser or any other apparatus. Due to the round bottom of this flask, uniform heating of the substance takes place when we heat the substance in the round bottom flask over the heating surface or over the heating mantle. This round bottom flask is used generally for the distillation, for the chemical reaction, for any chemical synthesis, and to heat the sample or the sample liquid it is used. Again, this is the round bottom flask of 1000 ml made of borosilicate glass. And this is the joint for the attachment, and this is used for the same purpose as we have told you about the long neck round bottom flask. Next, this glassware is called two neck round bottom flask, and this is 100 ml of round bottom flask made of borosilicate glass, and here you can see the two neck. This is the first neck and this is the second neck. And generally, this type of round bottom flask is used in different organic chemistry experiment, like during some chemical synthesis or during some chemical reaction, we fit the condenser to one neck and in the another neck, we fit thermometer inside it to observe the temperature of the content inside the round bottom flask during the whole process in order to control the temperature during the reaction, during the process. So this is how the round bottom flask is used for the different purpose. And according to the process, according to the requirement, we use one neck or two neck round bottom flask for the synthesis, for the reaction of any organic substance. And here, this is the three neck round bottom flask. Here you can see this is 500 ml of round bottom flask with three neck, and this is made up of borosilicate glass. This is the three neck of this round bottom flask. This is the first neck, this is the second neck, and this is the third neck. And these are the joints of this three neck for the attachments. This three neck round bottom flask is used for the complex reaction of different organic substance or organic synthesis or complex type of organic synthesis or in different experiment of the organic chemistry or the more complex reaction, more complex boiling, fractionation, purification process. This three neck round bottom flask is used. For example, if in any reaction or the synthesis we attach condenser to the one neck and in the second neck we attach thermometer inside it to control the temperature throughout the process, and in the third neck if we need to add any other substance during the experiment, the substance according to the process, then we can add the substance through this third neck. Means according to the requirement we can use one neck, two neck or three neck round bottom flask. Next, this thermometer is called laboratory thermometer, and by this thermometer we can determine the temperature of any substance or any solution. We can determine the boiling point of any substance. You can see here the different temperature range of this thermometer. The range is from 0 to 100, 200 to 200, 300, and it is up to 360 degrees Celsius. Means very high temperature of any substance up to 360 degrees Celsius we can determine by this laboratory thermometer, and high boiling point of any substance can be determined by this thermometer. And this is the mercury of this thermometer. This mercury expands, means move according to the temperature. Means according to the temperature or the boiling point of the substance, this mercury will move up to that mark given on the thermometer by which we can determine the exact temperature of that substance. Next, this glassware is called mortar pestle, and this is glass mortar pestle. This is called mortar and this is called pestle, and we can move this pestle like this over the mortar to prepare the mixture or to break the substance to the powder form, especially the soft material. This glass mortar pestle is stain resistant, means when we need non-staining, non-porous surface for any process, for any mixture preparation or for any grinding, then we have to use this type of glass mortar pestle. And because this glass mortar pestle is made up of glass, that's why it is used to grind the soft material, means to reduce the size of the soft material. But it is not used to grind the hard material, and this is generally used to incorporate large amount of the liquid. So this is all about the glasswares which are commonly used in the different laboratories. Thank you very much for watching this video.